If you ask me, he's the world's best inside man. Morgan Spurlock, he was known for Super Size Me and a million other things, and now he's going to be known for his ability to sniff out some pretty good weed. Have a look at the premiere, a little snippet that's coming up on Sunday night. Take a peek.
So I'm locked in the back of a blacked out van somewhere in Northern California, being driven to an undisclosed location where they grow vast amounts of marijuana. There's been some other stipulations that we have to follow now. We can't show any of the people who work there. We can't show any of the people who work there spaces. We can't show any hands or body parts. This isn't sketchy at all. We're driving into a building right now. Hear the dogs? Now they're closing the doors so that we won't know where we are. They're getting out.
Don't leave me there. Morgan Spurlock, inside man. Okay, first of all, you had me at body parts.
Yeah, oh good.
Then you had me at creepy.
Okay, good.
You know, I figured we're about 11 minutes to lunchtime.
Yeah.
So I thought, as we have our conversation, perhaps we could have a little bite to eat.
Yeah.
So I brought a little bit of some of your favorite things.
Oh, see, look at this.
Yep, Big Mac.
All the stuff that I would never eat. All this stuff that I would never indulge in.
A little Big Mac for two, and a couple of big tall Cokes, of course.
See, that is all you.
Everybody knows you.
That is all you.
From Super Size Me. I just want to watch as you stare this down, because I know you like the smell,
right? Yeah, the thing is about the food, like, the minute I smell it, my mouth does start watering like Pavlov's dog.
Come on.
Like, I am like, see, those they're not even, like, real. It's not even, like, a real French fry.
Have you
like,
had you know, one?
I have not. Like, here's the best part about this, is if you put this under, like, the seat in your car, in, like, 5 years, it'll still look just like this.
And smell the same.
And still smell just like
and
that.
And the smell of your car is pretty special, too.
And it'll smell just like that as well.
I'm just gonna prop that up right there for you
see, like,
the whole
lunch. If the world ended today, you know, 50 years from now, 5,000 years from now, aliens would come, and this is what they would find. They would find this pile of food. They would find our corpses and, like, this pile of food. Nothing will have decomposed except you and I.
Do you know what's amazing? I got to be honest. I watched Super Size Me. I was revolted by everything that happened to your body and everything else, and I still eat it all the time.
Well, that's
it's
why,
like candy.
That's why
you eat gummy bears. You know what's going on.
Well, but it's almost like as you eat it, you know, it's like since it doesn't decompose, it's just making you last forever. See, that's what it is. You're gonna live eternal now. It's gonna be great.
That's the secret
that's
of the
why
anchor
you look
woman.
So great.
Just chow down on a couple of
that's
Big Macs. Let's talk pot. This first episode is great.
No, it was a lot of fun.
What did you really do, and how much can you let out before Sunday's big premiere?
Yeah, no, so it's a great show. So the first episode is all about, you know, medical marijuana, and all the states now are pushing to have it. Other states are saying there's no way we should legalize this. It's a terrible idea. So I went to work at Harborside Medical, the largest medical marijuana dispensary in the United States, and I went there and became, you know, became your weed connoisseur. I worked behind the counter.
Dope
I was
guy.
Selling. I was the dope guy. I was your dope man. I was behind the counter hitting people up, you know, with Hindu Kush. And a little, you know, and a little purple Urkel and a little crazy train,
you
know,
some
whatever.
Free samples there, Morgan?
They were giving away some things as I worked there.
Yeah,
they
were cagey on me. Yeah. So did you learn anything that you didn't know? Did you find things you didn't expect?
I tell you the thing that I expected going in is that it was just a place where a bunch of stoners would go get their card and be like, dude, now I can go get my weed. government said so.
That's kind of what I thought.
But you go there and here are these people who had been, you know, because we live in a nation where we love to medicate people. You go to the doctor and here's a pill for this, here's a pill for that. And I was meeting people who were on 6-7 medications, were all strung out and addicted to these pills. And they started going to the clinic and started taking medicinal marijuana and are now off that medication. I met soldiers from Iraq, Afghanistan, who had massive PTSD, who couldn't have like relationships with their families or like hold down a job, that once they went on the medication, like now they are completely normal, can like have great relationships with their families and friends.
And notwithstanding the medicinal, you know, values. And I think that's been, you know, talked about.
Let's talk about the party values.
Let's talk about the dudes. Because honestly, I think there's a lot of people out there who come up with, you know, conditions like, I can't sleep, doc. Can you give me my good
I have
script?
A lot of stress.
Yeah.
How do I deal with that stress
and
without it?
And aren't they handing those things out kind of like water?
Well, we show in the show, it is pretty easy to get a card. You know, like I got mine. Fairly easily.
I've heard you honestly just have to say something like, I'm having trouble sleeping.
Yeah, it could be, and it could be that. It could be stress, could be insomnia, could be like muscle pains, you know. So it's not like there's an intense process of getting a card.
I love how you start with weed. That's pretty good stuff. What about the rest of the series? What other little special nuggets have you got?
We go from weed.
And you know what I say is nuggets, right?
Yeah, that's little nuggets. Little nuggets of knowledge.
Giving you a little
we go from that to guns.
Yeah.
Guns also a big hot topic in America. Immigration, illegal immigration, education. Probably my favorite episode, which is very personal to me, is we do one about elder care, kind of end of life care, where I move in with my 91-year-old grandmother.
You're
and become
kidding.
Yeah, so I become like her bosom buddy. I become her roommate, for about a week and a half.
How'd that go?
Well, once you move in with an old lady, funny things just happen automatically. So I'm living with a 91-year-old woman. It was it was pretty entertaining.
That sounds great. So every Sunday night
at 10 o'clock.
Yeah. For the next 8 weeks.
Right here on CNN.
And by the way, how did all this come about? You are sort of the inside man I remember from Supersize Me.
That's right. It seemed
like it was a natural, but how did it end up that you just chose these particular topics and ended up at my table?
Yeah, well,
speaking of, at your
somewhat delicious table.
Delicious table. Do you actually dare me to eat one of these right in front of you?
You can eat whatever you want.
You will not. You absolutely will not do this.
Your liver will be the one that'll hate you.
I was going to try and break news and get you to eat at least one Big Mac because I had a feeling you were telling the truth. I do love
Big Macs, but
I know
but they're not really like food. It's not real food. It's like you're biting into like beef plastic.
They are very real.
It's like beef plastic. It's what it is. It's like it's grown on a farm. It's like Monsanto's making those in some factory somewhere.
I can't wait to see what you got coming down the pipe. But I'm really distressed that you didn't eat any of that lunch.
Well, I'm going to leave it for you.
Then you can have a snack later.
You can have a snack later.
I have to read a tease like this now. Nice to have you with us.
Great to see you.
I love your work. Morgan Spurlock, coming up. As I said, the premiere is this Sunday night, right here, only on CNN. My mouth is full, and I'm not supposed to talk, so I'll be right back.